Hello friends, welcome back to another new video. In Linux system, you must have seen different types of compressed file formats like .tar, .tar.gz, .rar and many other formats. So in this video, I'm going to show you how you can compress and decompress files and folders in different types of format in Linux system. So let's get started. We will see some popular compressed file formats that you often see in Linux system that include zip, 7-zip, rar and tar files. So I'll be showing you how you can compress and extract a zip file, rar file, 7-zip or tar file. First we will see zip. To compress or decompress a zip file, you must have installed zip and unzip packages in your Linux system. These two packages are pre-installed in Linux system, but if they are not installed, you can use apt install zip and then unzip to install it. Okay, I forgot to add sudo. Sudo apt install zip and then password. See, zip and unzip is already the newest version. So now that we have installed the zip and unzip in our Linux system, let's see how you can zip a folder or a file and then how you can unzip it. Let me clear the screen now. Oh wow, clear, clear. And let me get in desktop directory. I've got a directory there. See, if I will do ls here, there is one file named ap.c and there is one directory named driver. So if I want to zip this ap.c file, I can simply type zip and then the zip file name, for example drive.zip, and then the file that I want to zip. I can type multiple or single file. Right now I will just add one single file, and then all you have to do is to just hit enter, and this will create a drive.zip file that includes ap.c file. See, if I will hit enter, see, adding ap.c deflated 74%. So if I will do ls, you can see driver.zip file, and if I will do ls.lh, you can see the zip file size, that is 20 KB, and the size of ap.c file was 74 KB. So the size is greatly reduced. Now how to unzip that zip file? First let me remove this ap.c file, and now if I want to unzip that driver.zip, all I have to do is to type unzip and then drive.zip, that is zip file name, and as you can see, we got our ap.c file back again. So this is how you can unzip and zip files. But for directory it is little bit different. See, the size is same too. Now let me show you how you can zip directories. It is little bit different. So first let me remove this drive.zip file. For that I need to type rm and then the file name, that is drive.zip. Now that we have removed driver.zip file, see, we don't see it anymore. You can use zip dash dash help command to see all the arguments that you can use with zip command. See here, dash f for fresh and dash d for delete entries in zip file, and there is one command, that is dash r, that is recurs into directories. So while creating a zip file of directories, you need to use this dash r argument. What this argument will do is that it will get inside directory and then zip all the files, and if there are more directories in that directory, it will get inside them too and then zip all the files with perfect path. So let me show you what happens if you don't use it and what happens if you use it. Here is our driver directory, and if I want to zip it, if I will type simply zip and then the zip file name, for example driver.zip, and then the directory that I want to zip like driver, and then hit enter, you see adding driver stored 0%. So now let's try to unzip it, but before that let me change this driver directory to driver 1 so that it won't conflict when I unzip it using mv command. And now let's unzip driver.zip using unzip command. For that just type unzip and the zip file name, that is driver.zip. As you can see, creating driver. Let's list all the files in driver to see if there are any files. See ls driver, we don't see anything. That is because that driver directory is empty. See, if I will open it in GUI, graphical user interface, the folder is empty. That is because the driver.zip did not store any file. See, this was our original directory. This is what happens when you zip a directory without using dash r command. So now first let me remove this driver.zip file and then the directory too. Okay, and then hit enter. Well, cannot remove driver, it is directory, so rm-rf driver. It is removed now. Now let me rename back driver1 directory to driver. It is done. And let me clear the screen now. And now let's try to zip it using dash r command. For that, what I have to do is I have to type zip and then dash r. And then the zip file name that I want, for example driver.zip file. the same driver driver.zip, and then the files or directory that you want to zip. For example, if I want to zip driver directory and then the ap.c file at the same time, I can do that. And if you want to encrypt your zip file, you can use dash e argument to do that. Well, it's not mandatory to use dash e at last. You can use it anywhere, or you can use it with dash r. See, enter the password for your zip file and then verify it again, and after that it will create a zip file named driver.zip, and it will add all the files in the directory because we use dash r argument too. And now if I will do ls-lah, you can see here that the zip file size is 2.3 MB. Now let's see the size of our driver directory so that we can compare how much it has been compressed. So for that, first I will get inside driver directory, and then I can use this command, that is du-sh, to see the size, that is of 11 MB. So our driver directory is of 11 MB, as you can see here. And now if I will go back and see the size of the zip file, that is 2.3 MB. So it has been greatly compressed, as you can see here, 11 MB file got compressed to 2.3 MB. Now if I will try to open this driver.zip file, as you can see, we see all our files in this zip file. And if I will try to extract any file, it will ask for password because we use dash e to encrypt it. Now first let me rename this driver directory to driver1 using mv command so that we can unzip that zip file without conflicting. So now that we have done it, let's unzip it using unzip command. So for that you have to type unzip and then the zip file name, that is driver.zip. And if I will hit enter, it will ask for password. So specify the password, that was 123456, and then it will extract everything. We forgot to rename our ap.c file, so it is asking if you want to replace it, then type yes and then no for n. So I will do yes for yes, and then it has been replaced. So now we have unzipped everything. So if I will do ls, I can see a driver directory and driver1 directory. So driver directory just got extracted. So if I will list all the files in driver directory, as you can see, these are the files in driver directory, and these are the files in driver1 directory. These are same. So this is how you can zip and unzip files and directories in Linux system. But what about 7-zip? How you can compress a file into 7-zip format and then extract it? To compress and extract 7-zip files in your Linux system, you need to have this package installed, that is named p7-zip-full. So just type sudo apt install p7-zip-full to install it. See, it is already installed in my system. See, p7-zip-full is already the newest version. Now that we have installed this package, to compress a file or directories into 7-zip format, all you have to do is to type 7z and then the 7-zip file name, for example a.7z, and then the directories that you wanna add, for example ap.c file I wanna add, and then driver directory. And then all you have to do is to just hit enter. Oh wait, I forgot, first you need to do this. Oh, I forgot, because I used a.7zip, you need to use this a argument to say 7-zip space a is for compressing the files, and then the file name, zip file name, let's change it to something else or it will create confusion, drive.zip. See, remember this a is for compressing the files, and then you need to write the file name and then all the files and directories that you want to compress. 407 items to compress, and it is now compressed. See, archive size is something like 132802 bytes, that is 1.3 MB drive.7zip file. So the size of 7-zip file is less than the zip file, so the compression is high in this 7-zip format. Now that we have compressed the file into 7-zip format, how you can decompress it or how you can extract it? So for that, all you have to do is to just change this a to e, that is the command will be 7-zip e and then the zip file name, that is drive.7zip. And I will remove this ap.c and driver, and then just hit enter. After you hit enter, it will extract everything that is in that zip file. See, I hit enter, but you know, my PC got lagged, because you will see now what will happen on my desktop. It is asking me if I want to replace the existing file, that is ap.c. so I will do is to skip it, and now it is being extracted. As you can see right now on my desktop, all the files and folders are extracted on my desktop, but with not perfect path. As you can see, all are just extracted here. So 7ze command extracted the 7z file, but it extracted all the files on my desktop without perfect path and everything. As you can see here, if I will do ls, let me first clear the screen, and then if I will do ls, as you can see here, all the files are on my desktop directory, even though these files were in their separate directories in the zip file. So this is what will happen if you will extract a 7z file using e argument. So first let me just delete all these files, and then we will see how to uncompress or extract a zip file in a perfect way so that we won't end up like this. So rm-rf* to delete all the files in my desktop directory. See, it will take some time, as you can see here, and everything is deleted. Now I need to get back my driver directory. So here is my driver directory and ap.c. I got them back after I deleted everything. Now to zip a file, as I told you already, to in a 7z format, all you have to do is to type 7z and then a argument to compress it, and then zip file name, for example driver.7z, and then the files or directories that you want to zip, like driver and ap.c. You can also use -p argument to password protect it, and then enter the password for your 7z file, and then verify it, and then it will compress all the files in 7z format. See, everything is okay. Now that we have created another 7z file, now let's see how you can decompress it. This is our 7z file, let me show you. See, it is of 1.3 MB, driver.7z. Now how to extract it in a perfect way? So for that, you have to just make a minor change. But before that, let me rename this driver directory to driver1 so that it won't conflict. Driver1. Oh, mc not found. Oh wow, mv command. You need to use mv command to rename it. Last time while extracting a 7z file, we used this command 7ze and then file name. So you need to just change 7zx instead of e. You need to write x, and then all you have to do is to enter the file name and then hit enter. After that, enter password if it is password protected, and it is asking for that ap.c file what you have to do. So I will just skip that file, and now everything is okay. Everything is now extracted. As you can see, we got driver directory that contains all of our files instead of all the files on our desktop directory. So this is how you can compress files or directories into 7z format and then extract them. But what about RAR format? To compress files or folders into RAR format, or to extract RAR files, you need to have RAR and UnRAR installed in your Linux system. As you can see, both of these packages are already installed in my Linux system. You can also install them using sudo apt install RAR and UnRAR. Now to compress a file or directory into RAR format, you need to type RAR and then A and then the RAR file name and then the files or directories that you wanna compress, and then you can use -p to also password protect it, same like our 7z. As you can see here, we have created a RAR file. Now first let me remove this file and directory, and then we will see how to extract a RAR file. It is removed now, and now there is our driver.rar file. To extract it, you need to type unrar and E and then the RAR file name. If it is password protected, enter your password and then specify A to use the same password for all files. It is extracted now. All files are extracted same like 7z. See, I used E argument, and then all the files are extracted in desktop directory without their own private directories and everything. So first I'm going to move this driver.rar file in trash so that I can easily restore it, and then I will delete all this file using rm-rf* command. Now that everything is removed, let me restore my driver.rar file, and then now to extract it perfectly, we can use this command. Say instead of E, we need to use X argument, and then just hit enter. Enter the password if it is password protected, and it will be extracted. Use the password for all, yes, and it is done. So this is how you can compress files or directories into RAR format and then extract RAR format in your Linux system. But what about tar file? Tar is most commonly used in Linux system. So to compress files into tar format or to extract tar files, you need to have tar installed in your Linux system. As you can see, it is already installed in my system. Now to compress files or directories into a simple tar format, all you need to do is to use tar and then -cvf. and then the tar file name, for example driver.tar, and then the files or directories that you want to compress. And this will compress all the files into a simple tar format. So if I will do ls-lah, you can see the compressed file size is 11 MB. So the compression is not that much good in tar format, but it is fast. Now to extract it, first let me remove these files and then we will extract it. We use this command, let me show you this command to compress a file into tar format. So to extract it, all you have to type is tar, and then instead of cvf, xvf, you need to type xvf and then the tar file name, for example driver.tar, and then hit enter. This command will extract normal tar format. As you can see here, we got our driver directory back. But there are other two types of tar format. Let me show you how to compress files in those tar formats and then extract them. So the next one is tar.gz. This type of tar format gives you best compression and then with the use of less CPU. See, to extract the file into tar.gz format, all you have to do is to add one argument, that is z argument, and then you have to just change your file name to tar.gz and then hit enter. This will create a tar.gz file. See, it is done now. And then let me first clear the screen, and then ls-lh. As you can see, the size of the tar.gz is 2.0 MB. The compression is very good here. And now to extract a tar.gz format, all you have to do is to type tar and then zxvf and then the tar file name, for example driver.tar.gz. see, tar-zxvf and then the tar file name, and then hit enter. As you can see, our tar.gz file has been successfully extracted. Now there is the last format, that is tar.bz2. bz2 format gives you a best level of compression, but it consumes a little more time and CPU. So to compress files or directories in tar.bz2 format, you need to use this command. Let me show you. See, instead of, this is the command that we used to compress a file into tar.gz format, you need to just change one argument. Instead of z, you need to use j, and then just change the extension to tar.bz2 and then hit enter. This will compress your file or folders in bz2 format. Say if I will hit enter, it is taking us some time. As you can see here, now it is done. And then if first let me clear the screen, and then if I will do ls-lh, I can see the file size, that is just 1.6 MB. So the compression is great. And now to extract it, all you have to do is to simply just change this c to x and then remove all the files. So tar.jxvf and then the file name, that is driver.tar.bz2, and then hit enter. This will extract it. As you can see, it is extracted now. So this is how you can compress files and folders in Linux system into different formats and then extract them. I hope you have found this video useful. If yes, then don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel. I will see you in next one.